In the course of the past 2 days, you and ourselves have been discussing the future of healthcare with the emphasis on influence of technology. And I think often you must have thought, as I did, it's amazing. This will really change healthcare. This will really change healthcare fundamentally. And you were probably right. Normally, when I give a speech, people expect answers. This time, I'm the one who is expecting the answers from you. Because, well, let's see in this audience, there are very smart people here in this audience. A room full of people, smart people. And for a politician, a technology is a difficult thing. When Steve Jobs said, always in his speeches, one more thing, it was never just a thing. This thing often changed the world. In this age of technology, it often seems that things change the world more than politicians do. These things influence every part of our daily life. Like the Minister of Health, she said in a speech at the beginning of this Congress, with a simple app of her cell phone, she's able to scan any product on gluten. A great example of very small innovation with a huge impact on her life and that of millions others over everywhere in the world. And I think that integrating technology in healthcare is therefore an autonomous movement, an autonomous development. Our generation is used to tablets and smartphones and computers, and we take them for granted, and that won't change if we get older. Nobody has to teach us how to Skype with our grandchildren or order groceries on the internet or use a tablet to communicate with our doctor or a nurse practitioner. Right now, 2016, I see that however self-evident smartphones and tablets are and smartwatches, e-health is not, or at least not yet. At least not yet in daily healthcare. So many inventions, so many new things, but we don't use them. And this, that's why I'm very glad to be here and to have this discussion with you. A meeting like this can help me to scale up the healthcare in our country, and we're always talking about in the future this and in the future that, but the future is now and we need healthcare, e-healthcare now. And especially in my field and the care for the elderly and the chronically ill, there's still so much we can do. Maybe it's a bit less spectacular than ICT used in operation rooms, because it's about small things. But smart things and small things can be a big help. How can we make life easier for the elderly? The policy of our government is to let elderly people, if they want, to live in their own familiar house as long as possible, without the feeling to need to move to a retirement home. So let them keep control about their own lives. Decide how they want to spend their days. How do we want to live? And I'm very much convinced that technology can be of help to achieve this goal. During the 3 years I have been state secretary, I've seen many beautiful examples. Elderly people staying in contact with medical and social advisors via the screen of their TV or their tablet. Or sensors to prevent people, it was just already in a discussion, from falling out of bed. Or small robots that can give a hand in everyday tasks in keeping fit, both physically and mentally. Already many elderly and disabled people use these kinds of technology. I once visited what was called the pulse warning in Arnhem, on the location of a famous, what's called in Dutch, the village, a special village for handicapped people. And I spoke to a resident there and he told me, well, he couldn't move any part of his body except his head. And he said, well, every evening a nurse came to me and said, what kind of TV program do you want to watch tonight? And what time should I come in to put off the television? And he told me, with new technology, fairly little things, he could watch TV when he wanted to, he could close the curtains when he wanted to, he could dim the lights if he feels like it. And he told me it was a wonderful feeling because I'm not dependent anymore from someone who asks me what I want. Living with dignity, that's our motto in taking care of the elderly and disabled. And technology will help us to realize it. On my way back to The Hague, I thought to myself, this is the way to go. Let's just simple do it. A lot of these applications would be interesting for any house, not just for the houses of disabled people. But we should be aware, it was already in discussion, that this is not an easy task. The road to this new way of living, maybe a new way of thinking, is very bumpy and we have to learn to ride it. Professionals have to learn to maybe lose control. They fear of losing control. They have to learn to let go. And one more example, in a home for elderly people with dementia, they use an ICT system that ensures that residents are not faced with locked doors and can still go out for a walk, despite their advanced dementia. Thanks to the GPS transmitter embedded in their bracelet, every resident bears one, the staff always know where they are. If a resident wanders off too far, the staff can alert volunteers living in the neighborhood. A volunteer goes out to meet a person and puts him at ease. They might even have a cup of coffee together, and a staff member accompanies them, the resident, back to home. It works fine, it works very good, but it takes very much time for the medical staff needed time to trust the system, to let go. Elderly people are sometimes afraid that they will be left alone with robots and television screens, and there will be nobody to touch them or to hug them. Families have to learn to hand over practical things to others and replace these tasks by loving attention. Don't think my father is perfectly okay now because the groceries are provided by the mobile supermarket, or the washing and the cleaning is done by the cleaning ladies, and the food is delivered. But that will never be enough. Robotica will always be an extra, a way for people to spend more time doing things that really matter, talking, spending time together, go for a walk, or go for a ride. Because let's always remember, technology is about things, life is about people, about paying attention, about love, and robotica can perhaps replace handwork, it can never replace love and personal attention. The attention of the Dutch government pays to the future of health doesn't stop today. Lucien van Engelen already thought about it. During the 1st of June, the Dutch presidency of the European Union will organize an e-health week, and one of the central themes will be patient empowerment. And many things I heard today I will take to this conference. There will be a special track on innovation and transition, where we'll pay attention to the changes needed in organization and finance, and indeed to scale up e-health. And on Tuesday the 7th, we organize the startup to scale up day, when innovative and small and medium firms and financial partners will be supported to realize their ambitions in the field of health, caring and supporting. As we already talked at the table, our plans for the coming years, the Dutch government promised the Dutch people that within 5 years, we want 80% of chronically ill patients who have access to their medical records, their medical records, their own medical records. We want self-testing to be available for 75% of chronically ill patients and vulnerable elderly people. 75% who are chronically ill, self-testing. And we want everyone to receive care or assistance at home to have access to online care and consultations. I think these goals are realistic and ambitious. Realistic and ambitious at the same time. Realistic because it's technically possible. We do have these things already. But they are also ambitious because they have an enormous effect how healthcare organizations will change in the light of these developments. Later this year, we will be able to inform the progress we have made in achieving these goals, and I hope you will share all the experiences you have today in people in your own country. And that's how we will keep going on, working together to our, I think, shared goal, giving everybody who needs the best care possible and empowering patients. That's what's about e-health. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.